Yesterday, we had some severe weather. Of course, this severe weather was on the leading edge of some colder air that pushed through the nation. That colder air will be with us today and kind of breezy behind that storm system. We are looking at some critical fire weather conditions today over the central and southern plains, though. And then that severe threat builds once again in by Friday. So our severe weather reports here from portions of central and eastern Texas to the lower Mississippi Valley, stretching north into the Ohio Valley. Things were a little bit more intense as you headed closer to the Ohio and Tennessee Valley with some tornadoes as well. But in total, nationwide, almost 300 reports of severe weather. Out ahead of that front, we were quite warm. We made it into the 80s from Little Rock down to Brownsville, almost 90 degrees in that particular region, but anywhere from 5 to almost 15 degrees above average, whereas Kansas City post-front was almost 20, 25 degrees below average, and those winds were very gusty. In the panhandle of Texas, we made it to almost 50-plus miles per hour, same for Oklahoma City, and today's critical fire weather conditions do continue where red flag warnings have been posted. It will be mild, breezy, and dry. Winds could be gusting up close to 40 plus miles per hour there. But again, the severe threat is well off to our east today. Tomorrow, general thunderstorm threat in the Arklatex region turns into a slight risk of severe weather, though, by Friday. So in the meantime, we are going to be a little quieter. Just watch that thunder threat start to build back in as we take into the next few days. And the heavy rain will start to develop as we approach the weekend there as well.